As the COVID-19 hit the whole world, it taught us a lot about economy, society, relationships, a lot of things that we take for granted. It showed us how fragile the systems we operate in, and at the same time, it showed us what really matters in our life. We had to manage and adjust so many aspects of our everyday life during this year. So when I really look back at 2020 and what I have learned, or how can I make things better, there are these three things which I think puts everything in perspective. So I thought, why not sharing it with the whole world? Maybe someone can benefit from it. Number one, we understand the value of something when we lose it. Difficult time really shows us how important family is for us. Looking around, seeing how people are losing their beloved ones, their friends, their neighbors, their parents, borders were closed. It was impossible for me to meet my parents who were living 1,000 miles apart. The only thing I could do is just sit and pray to Allah so Allah will keep them safe. Take care of your family, take care of your parents when they are still alive. Wallahi, even if the whole world turns their back onto you, your parents will be still there for you. Parents are blessings, they are not burden. Number two, whatever we are going through is temporary. Another thing that all of us know, but we don't really internalize it. We kind of overlook the fact that regardless of sufferings or blessings, it is temporary. This life for us, it's like a journey. It's a mean to get to our destination. And what really matters is not the flawed beginning, rather a good ending. Number three, death is inevitable. If you take a look how we are leading our life, it's more like we forgot that we have to die. We took our life for granted. We're living as if we will never die. Even the mere thought of death makes us uncomfortable. But truth of the matter is, death won't escape anyone. Someone will taste it sooner, someone will later. But the question is, what do we want to leave behind? What do we want to live for? What purpose are you serving? This pandemic really made me think and ponder over those existential questions. Imam Hassan al-Basri said, "How strange it is that person whose departure from this world to the next has been announced, and whose predecessors have already been departed, still plays around." Khalifa Umar bin Abdul Aziz, on his last sermon, shared the reality of life. He praised Allah and said, "You are not created in vain, nor will you live without a purpose. Verily, you have an appointed time in which Allah, the Most High, will come down to judge you. Wretched and ruined will he be who leaves the mercy of Allah and is denied a garden whose width is that of the heavens and earth. Don't you know? No one will be safe tomorrow, except one who is wary of today and fears it, and sells the transitory for what will remain, and the little for plenty, and fear in exchange for security in the hereafter. Don't you see that you are in the loins of the dead, to be taken by those who remain after you, until all matters return to the best of inheritors? Every day in the funerals, you accompany those returning to Allah, the Mighty and Sublime, having spent their time until you hide them in a crevice, in the ground, in the belly of a bare and unfurnished hole, having parted from their loved ones, stroking the dirt and facing their accounts. Now they're dependent on their deeds, free of what they left behind, in need of the deeds they put before them. So fear Allah before the time He appointed is up and death descends upon you. This is what I have to say."